I have a great pleasure in welcoming our Vice Chancellor, Professor V.S. Rao Garu, for the webinar, what we titled as Inspiring the Inspired and explaining the exciting research opportunities that have been created and that are available at SRM University, AP. Professor V.S. Rao is well known for his contributions as in charge vice chancellor at BITS Pilani and also as director of BITS Pilani Hyderabad. He is an institution builder and he has made BITS Pilani highly reputed, BITS Pilani Hyderabad as a very reputed institution in a very short time. And he is a simple person, amenable and acceptable and approachable to all of us for guidance, suggestions, and support. So we look forward to the Vice Chancellor to take this institution, SRM AP, to greater heights. With this brief introduction, I extend a warm welcome to all the participants, the faculty members of SRM University AP, the PhD students of SRM AP, and also the potential students for PhD programs at SRM AP. Now I request the Vice Chancellor to address the participants of the webinar and motivating them to join for PhD programs at SRM AP. Yes, sir.
Very good morning to all of you, my dear friends. Thank you, Professor Narayan Rao Garu, for your kind words. I am very happy to be part of this important webinar, Inspiring the Inspired. I think you have aptly got the thing for our PhD seminar for prospective students. It's very apt title. I have joined SRM University a week ago, exactly on last Wednesday. Yesterday, I was given my induction on the research progress at SRM University. And the second event is this Inspiring the Inspired. I'm really excited being a part of this exciting webinar for prospective PhD students. SRM University is pursuing the path of excellence by laying a very strong emphasis on research right from its inception. In its goal to accomplish, to reach or to become a university of excellence, I'm sure that I do not have to explain how important it is for research going forward, both at undergraduate education, postgraduate education. So accordingly, the university decided to recruit only well-accomplished research faculty, those who have done either PhD from a reputed institution from India or abroad, with at least some international exposure through their postdoctoral, if they have done their PhD from any reputed institution like Jadavpur University, IISc Bangalore, or IITs or NIT. So mostly reputed institutions, PhDs with postdoctoral experience, they have been recruited by this university. In a matter of less than 3 years of existence as a university, and a faculty with an average engagement of 2 years have really published around 200 research publications in very well-reputed journals with very high impact factor. It's really, really incredible. To my knowledge, there is no university which has accomplished to this extent in such a short time, be it in terms of research publications or be it in terms of research funding from DST DBT, there are around 24 projects to the tune of around 12 crores. It is all because of committed, dedicated young faculty who have been working relentlessly in their pursuit for excellence in research. My compliments to all faculty members. And it's in fact, in India, research has taken a back seat for various reasons. If you compare number of PhD students, India with Europe or other developed countries, USA, so we are far, far below, maybe 100 times or even many more times below in terms of PhD students. Now the time has come. We have to participate. Higher education institutions have to participate in research and development by encouraging PhD students. So this institution, with less than 3 years of existence, have admitted around 100 PhD students. The exact numbers, I think, will be presented by Professor Narayan Rao Garu. I may be wrong by a few numbers here and there. So very good number of PhD students in the initial years itself is really commendable. So once again, I must compliment all our faculty in all disciplines, starting from sciences to humanities to engineering, so who have been taking a lot of interest in research. More importantly, it is a matter of pride for me and for the university, for our faculty to involve undergraduate students in their research pursuit. So there are publications. There are good number of patents filed by our faculty. Around 15 patents have been already filed. And one student is also involved in this patent filing. So all these are really commendable for R&D efforts of this university. So I must thank all of you. And it has all become possible because of your efforts and also the able leadership of Professor Narayan Rao Garu, who has got excellent research accomplishments in his career. He has been associated with SRM University for more than 4 decades and directing the research efforts of SRMIST earlier and now SRM University AP. Under his guidance, our research progress is really commendable, and we have made good collaborations with industry and R&D laboratories, which will be explained by Professor Narayan Rao Garu later. So I wish all of you a very good session today, and I welcome all of you to SRM University, all prospective students. So thank you all.
Yeah, thank you very much, sir. So now I will request Professor D. Narayan Rao to present his presentations on the research overview of SRM University.
Our beloved Vice Chancellor, Professor V.S. Rao Garu, my colleagues of SRM University, Andhra Pradesh, the deans, faculty members, the PhD students, and the prospective students who are participating in this webinar from different parts of the country, I extend a cordial and warm welcome to all of you. The purpose of this webinar is to explain the type of exciting research that's going on at this university in frontline and emerging areas of science and technology, and motivate the students to join SRM University for PhD, their PhD programs. And we assure you, the prospective students, that will provide you illustrious research career in India and abroad. I will substantiate my statement. The reason being, our faculty members, as the vice chancellor said, are highly accomplished. They obtained their PhD degrees from the most reputed universities and institutions from India and abroad. This almost equal that you will be going to US universities and working for your PhD programs. Now, your preferred destination could be SR University Andhra Pradesh to carry out such quality research by joining PhD students of SR University. Don't think I am making a marketing speech. You will realize what I am saying is true when we walk through the presentation, which now I wish to make. As I said, I'll give an overview of research activities that are being carried out at SR University Andhra Pradesh. I may not be able to cover all aspects, but I will try to cover some of the significant features and aspects of the research that are being carried out at this university. Ranjit, I am trying to make it full screen. Okay. This shows the model of the plan of SRM University Andhra Pradesh in the next 5 to 10 years. It will be amazing. You may not be able to find such campus anywhere in the country. We have established the university and we are evolving as a world-class university, and we would like to have engineering, management, medical and health sciences, science and humanities, and law, and also liberal arts. Presently, we are offering programs in engineering and technology, management, sciences, and also liberal arts, and we will start medical and health sciences and other programs in a phased manner in the years to come. The university was inaugurated on 15th July 2017 by the Vice President of India, Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu. As the Vice Chancellor said, this university is just 3 years old, not even three completed, but just 3 years old. But at the same time, with the accomplishments and the expertise of our faculty, we could carry out a good amount of quality research at SRMAP. Presently, we have 2,187 students from 25 states of the country. What I am trying to say is this university has national characteristics. In the first year of its existence itself, the university could attract students from 18 states of the country. And also we have 49 students from 10 different countries. Thus, this university is very keen on having national and international characteristics at SRM University, Andhra Pradesh. This shows the academic and administrative block. Here our motive and goal and the idea is to provide conducive environment for creative thinking, because we are trying to attract research scholars who create knowledge. So we want to provide very conducive environment for creative thinking. You can look at this academic and administrative block, the world-class quality infrastructure. This is what we call atrium, meant for informal get-togethers and informal meetings of the students, faculty, or research scholars to exchange their ideas, to share their ideas, and to discuss. They can discuss anything they like. This shows the dining hall, which is again very quality infrastructure. And this picture shows the inside of the dining hall. I'm not going to bore with infrastructure. Soon I'll move to the research activities. Yeah, this is one of the hostel blocks. We have such five blocks. This shows one block. And also I'll show you a twin sharing hostel room. This is the mechanical engineering laboratory which we have established for undergraduate students, as well as some of the experiments could be done by the PhD students. This is the electrical engineering laboratory. We have introduced digital examinations at SRM University, not because of COVID, 3 years back itself, realizing the potential need and the importance of digital examinations. As the Vice Chancellor mentioned, we have appointed 132 faculty members. They have obtained their PhD degrees from reputed universities and institutions from abroad, from IISc, IITs, and other premier institutions. We could get 4 foreign nationals as faculty members. This is our fortune, we can say. Presently, 59 research scholars are pursuing their PhD programs in different disciplines. These PhD students are from 9 states. Why I'm telling is, we want research students from different parts of the country, the cross culture, and the national characteristic. This picture shows, periodically, we conduct PhD review programs. Professor Jayasilan coordinates that. Maybe once in 3 months, we organize such review meetings for all research scholars. This picture shows one of the such review meetings of the PhD programs. We have active learning center where the presentations can be made, and also research scholars and students can could sit and discuss their innovative ideas. Presently, we have 4 faculty members who are DST inspired faculty. Generally, DST inspired faculty are highly prolific, which we are observing through their publications and all. Dr. Mannadhan and Mahesh Kumar Rawa from the Department of Chemistry. I'm sure after this presentation, you'll break out and you could discuss with some of them. Dr. Manjunath Thondamal from Department of Biology and Mallikarjun Rao from the Department of Physics. And we have Anil Suresh in the Department of Biotechnology, the DBT Ramalingaswamy Fellow. Once again, I say, this is a honor and prestige for any university to have DST inspired faculty and also fellows such as Dr. Ramalingaswamy Fellow. And today, we published 192 papers. Of course, a few are in the acceptance stage, have been published by the faculty members and research scholars of the University of Andhra Pradesh. The average impact factor is 4.17 and the maximum impact factor is 52.17. That speaks the high quality of publications that are coming out from SRM University by the faculty members and the research scholars. I'm also glad to inform that SRM was ranked as 21st rank by Nature Index ranking. We got the 21st rank amongst all universities and institutions, including IITs in the country. And amongst the private institutions and private universities, SRM got the first rank. Dr. Nimai Mishra, Dr. Sabyasachi Chakravarti, and Dr. Mahesh Kumar Rawa from the Department of Chemistry, you will definitely have a chance to discuss with them. And Dr. Sudarshan from the Department of Biotechnology, Dr. Siddharth Ghosh, and Dr. Jatish Kumar Dash from the Physics Department, their 6 publications contributed in getting this respectable and high ranking by the Nature Index. This is again a prestige and privilege for any institution. We are happy that even with the 2 years of age, we could go reach that stage. patents, 13 patents we have filed so far. 8 patents have been published. They are from different departments, Department of Computer Science, Mechanical Engineering, Mathematics, and others. 5 patents out of 13, 8 have been published, 5 are in the filing state. See, usually after filing, it takes some time to get published. That's why these are in the filing stage. As the Vice Chancellor mentioned, one patent, face shield for humans has been filed by of the second year BTech student. Thus, we encourage the students, research scholars, and faculty members to apply for patents. 24 research projects with a total outlay of 12 lakhs of rupees have been sanctioned to the faculty members of this university by the DST, the Department of Science and Technology, the Department of Biotechnology, DBT, Board of Research in Nuclear Science, BRNS. These are all the scientific agencies of the country, and also by the British Council. SRM University AP got the recognition certificate from the Department of Scientific and Industrial Research of the Ministry of Science and Technology of the Government of India. This is again a prestige for a nascent university, which is 2 or 2.5 years old, to have such a recognition by the DSIR. We have established and establishing 17 research laboratories. You can see this building, what we call as X-Lab, where most of the research facilities are established and are being established. We have made international collaborations with MIT, the most prestigious institute in the world, University of California, Berkeley, Illinois Institute of Technology, Engineering School of Information and Digital Technology of France. Also, we have established research collaborations with some of the well-known institutions in India. I'll just mention a few. We have established collaboration with Sri Venkateswara Institute of Medical Sciences. It's a super specialty institution located at Tirupati, and also All India Institute of Medical Sciences at Mangalagiri. Some of the joint studies that are being carried out are non-invasive glucose monitoring, 3D bioprinting of organs, tissues, and prosthetics, medical imaging analysis and machine learning, cancer diagnostics. So this provides opportunities for the research scholars to get involved in some of these projects which are of national importance and having societal applications. We also established research collaboration with the well-known and premier CSIR, Indian Institute of Chemical Technology at Hyderabad. The objectives of this collaboration are visit of IICT scientists to SRM University AP as visiting scientists and adjunct faculties, joint research supervision by IICT scientists and SRM AP faculty members, access to major research facilities and instruments available at IICT and to carry out research by the faculty members and research scholars of SRM-AP, SRM-AP student internships and training at IICT, joint research proposals to be submitted to the funding agencies by IICT scientists and faculty members of SRM-AP. We have collaboration with Indian Nanoelectronics Users Program, INUP, at Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. This shows the picture of two research scholars, Ashwini and Ramya. Their proposals have been selected for implementation under INUP at the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. These research scholars are working with Dr. Sabyasachi Mukhopadhyay of the Department of Physics. Why I am mentioning here is the research scholars will have great opportunities to work at such centers. This is the unique center in India where they have a FAF facility and all facilities, state art experimental facilities such as the TAM, FESAM, XPS, Raman spectrometer, and you name the instrument they have. Also, when you go to such programs in UP, you will have interaction with the well-known faculty members of IISc Bangalore, including the fellow of the Royal Society, Professor Ajay Sood, and other research scholars. That will expand your horizon of thinking and carrying out research. Also, we have collaboration with National Atmospheric Research Laboratory, NARL, an autonomous institution under Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO. Some of the proposed joint studies are characterization of non-linear and linear properties of the atmosphere with an idea of application towards free space optical communication. I'll just describe this. Today, optical communications in the country and in the world are only through optical fiber cable OFC. There are no cableless optical communications today like wireless, but this will be the future for free space optical communications. This is a very emerging area. That's why Dr. Gangireddy of the physics department is working with NARL on this project. Also, can urban heat island effect be delineated from global warming? Because if you look at cities like Delhi, Mumbai, Hyderabad, and other cities, there is global warming. How much is being contributed by climate change and how much is being supplemented by urban heat island? So such studies are of paramount importance. This picture shows the huge antenna of the Indian MST radar, that is mesosphere stratosphere radar. This is the second largest radar in the world. This has 1,024 antenna elements covering an area of 17,000 square meters. I repeat, 17,000 square meters, huge antenna. This is the marvel of modern electronics. We have collaboration with that institute to carry out research on antennas, propagation, communications, and signal processing, and also aspects like HHT. Many of you might have heard FFT, the fast Fourier transform. The recent one is HHT, Hilbert Huang transform. Such innovative things could be carried out at this laboratory. This picture shows different types of radars like wind profilers having microstrip antennas capable of handling large amounts of power and operating in different frequencies. Research scholars who will be joining us can explore and innovate their ideas, making use of some of these facilities at different institutions. We have established NextTech Laboratory. This is particularly for the undergraduate students to carry out and implement their innovative ideas. We have established XRD laboratory, X-ray diffractometer laboratory, XRD means X-ray diffractometer, cell culture laboratory, genetics laboratory, gas analysis laboratory, and ceramics. We also established colloidal chemistry laboratory, device physics laboratory, organic synthesis laboratory. However, when you meet the faculty in the different departments, they'll give more details of the facilities available at these laboratories and also the type of research that's being carried out making use of these facilities. We have University Research Council with very, very high profile scientists and faculty members. This council is headed by Dr. V.K. Saraswat, honorable member, technical of Niti Aayog. Professor U.B. Desai, former director of IIT Hyderabad, Professor Satyanayana, present director of IIT Tirupati, Professor Appa Rao, Vice Chancellor of University of Hyderabad, Professor Kamana Chattopadhyay from Department of Materials Engineering, ISA Bangalore, Professor Balasubramanian, well-known mathematician from Institute of Mathematical Sciences, Chennai, Professor Desi Raju, an established chemistry professor from ISA Bangalore, Anil Kumar from National Chemical Laboratory, Pune, Dr. S.R. Rao, formerly senior advisor to the Government of India and Biotechnology, Dr. Sadadi, well-known entrepreneur and emeritus chairman of Shanta Biotech, Professor B.S. Murthy, the present director of IIT Hyderabad, Professor B.P. Sinha from ISI Calcutta, Dr. Padmanabham, director of ERCA, a very, very premier institute of the DST in Hyderabad, Professor G.P. Das from IIT Kharagpur, Professor Shyam Asolekar from Center for Environmental Sciences from IIT Bombay. Why I am mentioning all these names and institutions, the idea is we would like to have the wisdom from many of these people and the institutions to direct us and guide us what areas of research need to be carried out in contemporary times at this university. And also Dr. Saraswat, being member of Niti Aayog, he always looks for projects having national importance and great societal applications. At the same time, you can get patents and publications. This picture shows the first meeting of the University Research Council, which was held at SRM AP on 7th August 2019. They gave quite a few ideas which are being implemented at the university. We have organized an 8-week summer course on electronic design and electronic gaming design and development. We call it as Indian Gaming Development, in association with Kajaani University of Finland and Andhra Pradesh State Skill Development Corporation. 512 students from the 13 districts of Andhra Pradesh from several engineering institutions and colleges participated in this 8-week summer course. This picture shows the faculty members of Kajaani University training the students. We organized internet conference and transformations in engineering education, imparting futuristic skills during 15-17 July 2018, that is last year. 25 speakers, invited speakers from reputed universities from US attended and delivered the talks. 5 invited speakers from India delivered the talks on academia industry interaction. 300 faculty members from different engineering college institutions from all over the country participated. We organized international conference on green energy technologies for smart cities. About 250 members participated, out of whom 50 members are from abroad, scientists and faculty members from US, Canada, UK, Australia, Germany, France, Korea, China, Singapore, Indonesia, and from different institutions, national laboratories, and universities for the country. We organized Research Day on 31st January 2020, which was addressed by Dr. R. Chidambaram, former chairman, Atomic Energy, and former chairman, Scientific Advisory Committee to the Cabinet, who was the key functionary in Pokhran 2. Conceptualized this research day meant for the undergraduate students, postgraduate students, research scholars, and faculty members. We encourage the research, undergraduate students, as Vashans was mentioning, to carry out research even at undergraduate level if they have the wish and the aptitude. To motivate the students of undergraduate and PG programs and research scholars to present their papers, we conceptualize the idea of organizing the research day. In each discipline, the winners are awarded with gold and silver medals to motivate and encourage them to carry out further research. We have organized ACCMS International Conference on Material Genome in association with Asian Consortium on Computational Material Sciences, Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research, Bangalore, and the Tata Institute of Mathematical Sciences, Chennai. 43 invited talks were delivered by scientists and faculty members from US, Japan, South Korea, Singapore, Saudi Arabia, United Kingdom, Sweden, Norway, Taiwan, Malaysia, Thailand, and India. More than that, I will tell you the importance. Now, computational materials is become a very prominent subject. The reason is to design and develop a new material, either for defense applications or for space applications or for atomic energy applications or for any general application, it used to take 10 years. Anybody can discuss with the material scientists of DRDO, particularly Kamath. They say it was taking 10 years. Now with these computational materials, they can design a new material in a couple of years. You see the great advantage. So thus, the students of physics who are interested to join with us, if they wish, we will associate them with such contemporary frontline areas. We have Professor Ranjit Thapa working in computational materials. We have Mahesh Kumar Rawa working in computational chemistry. And thus, we have the expertise and the facilities to carry out research in frontline areas. On May 15th, we organized a webinar. The title of the webinar is Post-COVID-19, Resurgence of Indian Industry Research and Development. I strongly feel after COVID-19, India will have great opportunities. I'm ready for a debate. The reason being, many industries are pulling out from China. Japan government is giving money for the industries to pull out from China. The preferred destination for some of those industries will be India. Thus, the present students and research scholars will have great opportunities with these industrial resurgence. Keeping that in mind, we organized a webinar on May 15th on post-COVID-19, the resurgence of Indian industry and R&D in the country. This webinar was chaired by Dr. V.K. Saraswat, Honorable Member Niti Aayog. The other panelists were Dr. Satish Reddy, Chairman DRDO, Professor Ashok Jhunjhunwala from IIT Madras, Dr. Varsad Reddy, Emeritus Chairman Shanta Biotech, Dr. Akhilesh Gupta from the DST, Professor Prashant Mohapatra, the Vice Chancellor of Research from the University of California, Davis, Professor Damodar Acharya, former Director, IIT Kharagpur, and our Vice Chancellor, Professor V.S. Rao, Director of IIT Hyderabad, Dr. B.S. Murthy, and also Mr. Natarajan, MD of Titan Industries. Why I am mentioning this is, you, the research scholars, will have great opportunities to organize such things and get into R&D of industrial importance. We also organized a webinar. Okay, this webinar was attended by more than 3,500 participants, researchers. We organized webinar on 29th May. Here the idea is post-COVID-19, what will be the scenario of science and technology in India? This was chaired by Bharat Ratna, Professor N.R. Rao. The other invited speakers are Professor Ashutosh Sharma, Secretary of the Department of Science and Technology, Dr. Chandrasekhar, Director of CSIR IACT at Hyderabad, Dr. Shishibala Singh, Director of NIPER Hyderabad. We are discussing what will be the nature and scenario of science and technology in this country, what should be the strategies to take science and technology forward in this country. As a follow-up of one of the conferences which we held, International Conference on Green Energy Technologies for Smart Cities, on the day of the conference, we had a sideline meeting with the chairman of Amara Raja Batteries, as you know, the largest battery manufacturing industry in India, their business is more than that of Exide. So we had a meeting with the chairman, their CTO, CEO, and key functionaries. We discussed the idea of establishing Center for Energy Storage Devices at SRMAP. We had 2-3 hours discussion, and many of our faculty members have participated. I vividly remember what the chairman of Amaraja Batteries Limited told is, your faculty members are having spark. Thus, I am convinced to establish center here. Though my neighbors, means neighbors of Amaraja, IIT Tirupati and ISER Tirupati are knocking on their doors. He said, your faculty members have spark. I am convinced and I am deciding that we will establish the center. The objectives of this center being design and development of low cost ion electrode materials, fast charging for lithium ion batteries. Today, all over the world, people are talking of electric vehicles. By 2030, it is estimated that 30 to 40% of the vehicles will be electric. 2 hours back, one executive director of APSRTC called me and said, they are also going for electrical buses getting from an industry in Bangalore. Now, the constraints with electric vehicles are the cost of the battery is very high. Sometimes it's equal to half of the cost of the car, sometimes equal to the cost of the vehicle. And then another issue is charging, very slow charging. So keeping these things in mind, not that we are going to solve the problems of the world, but still we contribute. Design and development of low cost lithium ion electrode materials so that the battery cost could be reduced. And also fast charging for lithium ion batteries. This charging time is a severe constraint. Last year in Pune, vehicles were given to taxi drivers, and after 3 months, they returned the vehicles, saying that we can't afford to wait for 8 to 10 hours of charge. That is the scenario. So now Sujit Kalluri and Tausif Khan are working on fast charging of lithium ion batteries. Similarly, Parsarthi Maram and others of chemistry department, they are working on development of low cost lithium electrode materials. And then Dr. Jayaprakash of the Department of Mechanical Engineering came up with an innovative idea of 3D printing of lithium electrodes. This excited the Amaraja batteries to go for it. And another objective is beyond lithium ion batteries. When the world goes for electric vehicles, everybody today is talking of lithium ion batteries. I have not come across any other battery for vehicles. Where is that much of lithium in the world? Of course, in India, we don't have lithium. Even in the world, where is such abundance of lithium? So thus, people have to go beyond lithium. That's why our faculty member, Lakshman Patro and others, they're working on sodium ion batteries and others. What I'm telling is, this university wants to be a research intensive university and to be well known in the world for research. That's why we take up contemporary issues. See, the prospective students are going to join us. Any university is known because of its research contributions. You name MIT, Stanford, University of California, Berkeley, or Tokyo University, or NTU Singapore, or NUS Singapore. It is mainly or mostly because of their research accomplishments and research contributions. The management and the leadership of this university is fully aware of the importance of research. Thus, we do attach great importance to research to make SR University AP as a research intensive university, in addition to quality teaching and training. Of course, we are ambitious and we would like to establish the following centers of excellence: Center for Weather Forecast, Center for Energy Storage Devices, Jal Janak Rail, there's hydrogen powered train, which I will explain after a couple of minutes, Center for IoT Manufacturing, Center for Cloud Computing, Center for IoTs, Center for 5G Technologies. A few days back, the Department of ECE has organized an excellent webinar on 5G technologies. We are convinced that SRVAP needs to explore of establishing a center for 5G technologies, center for artificial intelligence and machine learning, center for satellite technology. SRM University has a great experience and expertise. We have designed, developed, launched a satellite made by the students of SRM University in Chennai in the year 2011. This was the first university in the country to launch a satellite. With such legacy, expertise, we would like to establish Center for Satellite Technology, Center for Renewable Energy, Offshore Wind Farms. I do not know how many students have heard of it. You can Google. This will be the future for wind energy. Center for Blue Economy, Center for Gene Editing CRISPR, and Center for Material Genome. As I said, this computational materials is becoming very, very important aspect all over the world. Coming to some of the centers which I mentioned, we have established on this metallurgical center in association with India Metallurgical Development Department. Rather, it is a joint center. It has been established at SRM University AP. This center provides weather forecast services for the entire state of Andhra Pradesh. Metallurgical Observatory has been established with automatic weather station, wind distance indicating wind equipment, sunshine recorder, rain rhythm gauge, and several other instruments, and they became operational in December 2018. Also, Capital Research, they have established here all-sky radiometer and ethylometer to carry out research on aerosols and black carbon. This picture shows the automatic weather station installed at the observatory by the government of Andhra Pradesh. This shows rain gauge, distance indicating wind equipment, sky radiometer, and black carbon analyzer, as I said, to carry out research on aerosols and black carbon. Now, this is a very interesting project. SRM University has signed an MOU with Integral Coach Factor, the Ministry of Railways, to design and develop a hydrogen powered fuel cell based train. This train will not use diesel or electricity. No carbon footprint. It will use hydrogen as input, and the fuel cell converts hydrogen into electrical energy. This is a very, very pioneering effort. As on today, only Alstom of Germany has demonstrated. India will be the second in the world in the next 3 years, and SRM will be a happy and proud partner of this endeavor. That's what I'm trying to say is, this university provides challenging and exciting opportunities to carry out research, as we titled our webinar, Exciting Opportunities at SRM. 3D printing of gold jewelry. This is an innovative concept arrived by Dr. Vinod Kumar of the Department of Mechanical Engineering. As on today in the world, only Cooks and Gold, Precious Metals UK, they are making 3D printing of gold jewelry with 18 carat. And that too gold powder. In India, as most of you are aware, 18 carat is not popular. We need to 3D print 22 carat gold jewelry. This has great grand technological challenges. Also, gold powder is not made in the country as on today. So Vinod Kumar wants to design 3D gold printing of gold ornaments using wire-based, and that too, 22 carat gold. This is being carried out in association with Tanishq Jewelers of Titan. Also, we are establishing Center for Additive Manufacturing in association with the well-known General Electric GE. This is again another innovative idea came from the Mechanical Engineering Department, particularly by Dr. Vinod Kumar, to use gold foam for gold ornaments, again in association with Titan, that is Tanishq Jewelers. You look at here, this bracelet, it has a high perceived look, solid look, but yet lightweight.
because he uses gold foam. Similarly, using the gold foam, he wants to make chains, bangles, rings. The concept, rather the driving concept, is high perceived look, solid look, but lightweight. Also, this will have aesthetic surface finish. This again is being done in association with Spanish Jewelers of Titan. Already, Dr. Vinod Kumar has a joint patent with Titan for hardening of gold alloy. I wish to emphasize here, this is the first joint patent filed ever by Tata Group. Now we have a plan to establish industrial research park at SRM University AP to provide opportunity for the faculty members, research scholars, and students to carry out research in frontline emerging areas of science, engineering, and technology, and also to cater to the needs of the industries of the country. SRM University students and research scholars will have industrial exposure and industrial experience by working as interns in the research park. We have an ambitious plan, as I said earlier, to set up 20 such laboratories in the next 5 years. The successful examples of industrial research parks are at the NTU, Nanyang Technological University in Singapore, and also IIT Madras. Now IIT Delhi also, Professor Ram Gopal Rao told recently that they are also establishing industrial research park. What I'm trying to say that these are all successful models which we also would like to have industrial research park at SRM University, AP. Thank you very much for your kind and patient listening to my elaborate presentation on the research activities of SRM University, AP. I'll be quite happy to have discussion with some of the prospective students, questions or clarification or discussion. Me, Vice Chancellor, and others will be happy to interact with the prospective students. Our idea is, we will never do marketing. Our idea is to excite and motivate some of the research students. Please join at SRM University AP. It is equivalent or similar to joining for PhD programs at some of the US universities, because we have faculty members with such expertise. We have established some facilities, we have established collaborations, and we are going to establish a few more facilities. Facilities alone will not take you to greater heights. The expertise needs to be coupled. My always statement is, if facilities and money is the criterion, quiet with its money power should have been the leaders in science and technology. They are nowhere near the leaders. Thus, infrastructure and money are needed, but more important and most important is the expertise, the vision, and the passion, commitment of the faculty members. All that we have here, which was demonstrated through the publications, patents, and high quality publications contributing to Nature Index ranking. So thus, I wish to encourage and motivate the prospective students to consider to join at SRM University, AP. And we will provide you illustrious careers. We almost assure you that. Coming to the logistics and infrastructure, SRM AP, those who wish to stay on the campus, we provide on-campus hostel accommodation and food at a very, very heavily subsidized. It's close to zero. You know, that is not the riding factor. The important factor is the expertise of the faculty members, which will make you as a leader in your chosen area of science and technology. I'm sure you will consider to join us. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, Professor Dinaran Rao, for your enlightening talk about the research activity at SRM University, AP. So now actually we will request if any participants or the students have any questions, they can raise their hand.
Ranjit, not request. You motivate them and encourage them to ask questions.
Yeah, I'm motivating the students actually that if you have anything in your mind to ask or related to research or any other things, you please raise your virtual hand through the Zoom app, or you can write in your chat box so that we can pass these questions to the Professor Dinarayan Rao or our Vice Chancellor.
So, Ranjit and Murali, when they raise their hand, can you unmute them? Can they ask the question on their own?
Yeah, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Please do that. When they raise the hand, please unmute them, both audio and video, and enable them to ask the question.
So, one of the participants, but this is related to our Gangi Reddy. So, let's, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Mr. Lobha Raju K. So you can ask your question. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah. Very good morning to Professor Dr. Narayan sir and Professor V.S. Rao sir. Nice, unstoppable speech regarding research activities is going on in WIT AP. Sir, myself, K. Lavaraju from Vignan University, Guntoru, Andhra Pradesh. Sir, I request you to, sir, lot of FDPs and workshop will put as in WIT, sir, for research activities. Hello? Am I audible, sir?
Please go ahead.
Sir, could you please provide any FDPs regarding machine learning, IoT, emerging technologies, upcoming?
Okay. We'll request,
yes, sir,
our faculty colleagues,
yes, sir,
to organize,
yes, sir,
FDP,
yes, sir,
on machine learning and other things.
Yes,
of
sir.
Course, SRV University Chennai has already started. From tomorrow, they are organizing. Yes, I'll, sir, pass on the details. Now, yes, I request our Vice Chancellor to supplement.
Okay, sir. Sir, those kind of FDPs and workshops links, please put in WhatsApp group. Like that thing is taken up some by WIT faculties. Please.
Okay. Right.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Raju. Mr.
Sir,
Raju.
Sir, Vice Chancellor, would you like to supplement?
Certainly, we would like to organize faculty development programs. So that would really enrich our faculty as well, and it would help many other institutions in the vicinity, and especially in the emerging areas like artificial intelligence, machine learning, robotics, process,
yes,
automation.
Sir, yes, sir.
So we would like to organize, and we would give wide publicity so that many faculty members from the local institutions can benefit out of it.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. So one more questions from Sonali Misra. So she wrote in the chat box. So my sister is interested to do PhD in biotechnology. She has completed MSc in biotechnology. What is the procedure for that?
Professor Jayasailan is here. Professor Jayasailan? Or anybody from
biotechnology? Yes, sir. I'm here, sir.
So then, please respond to that question, Jayasailan.
Yes, sir. Hello, Sonali Misra. In principle, your sister has to apply to our university for an entrance examination. I have sent a link.
No. Jayasailan, first you ask whether she is a DST Inspire Fellow or not.
Oh, Miss Sonali Misra, is your sister a DST Inspire Fellow or NET qualified candidate?
No, sir.
Okay.
Okay. So in that case, I have sent a link of our university to your chat box directly. You can see that the procedure, and you can tell to this your sister. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Jayasailan.
Yes, sir.
You can give your email ID for any further clarifications. Sonali's sister or Sonali could contact you.
Yes,
please
sir.
Provide them.
I'm providing my email ID to her directly, sir.
Okay, good, good.
Okay, sir. Miss Sonali, you can note down my email ID. It's already in your chat box.
Okay, sir. Okay, I'll put a mail on your personal mail so that we can clarify.
It's an official mail. It's an official mail. You can send it. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your interest.
Okay. So another questions from Belinda. So I have completed my MSc in biomedical genetics and would like to pursue my PhD under Professor Manjunath. May I know the procedure? I have not qualified NEET.
Okay. Professor J.C. Lan could explain the formality which he has already done. And Dr. Yes. Manjunath either can discuss now or when they can go to the breakout room can have further discussion.
Yes. Ms. Belinda, I am also sending you the link of the protocol, how to join our university for non-NET qualified candidates. So you can follow it. And of course, we can also discuss in the breakup room soon. Where Manjunath will be presenting.
Manjunath is here.
Yes, sir. Please,
Manjunath.
Yes, sir.
Please motivate that candidate now itself to come to you and join.
Sure.
Go ahead.
So, Belinda, thanks for interest in my lab. So, what I would suggest is after this, session, we will have a breakout session where I will be presenting in detail about the various opportunities, research opportunities, and the areas that our faculty in life sciences are working on. So please attend that session, and we can have more discussion. And since you already have a biomedical genetics background, if I'm not wrong, I think you already wrote once and you sent me CV, and also you have some research experience. But of course, we will discuss more, and we would be happy to have you, and we will also discuss the procedure to get into the PhD program at SRMAP.
Okay, so next course one raise hand is there. So it is from Pavan Kumar Mukku. So Pavan, Mr. Pavan, you can go ahead with your question.
Good morning, sir. My name is M. Pavan Kumar. I'm from Visakhapatnam. I completed my M.Tech in VLSI design domain in Gautam University.
Very good.
After completed my master's, I joined as a faculty in Raghu Institute of Technology, Visakhapatnam, around 5 years. I thank you, SRMAP, for conducting such a good, encouraging students who are ready to pursuing research work. Actually, I want to do research work in my VLSI domain. Sir, is there any opportunity for carried on PhD admission in low power VLSI in your SRM university, sir?
So are you contemplating part time or full time?
Actually, I want to do full time, sir.
Yeah, because as of now, we are not entertaining part time PhD students. Okay, regarding VLSI, faculty members from ECE department, anybody could respond. Professor Shankar, is he there?
Yeah, he is there actually. Ramesh?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. In VLSA, there are three faculty. Myself, Ramesh Vaddi, Professor Shivashankar, and Dr. Pradyut Kumar. So the candidate can, we can have an interaction separately.
During the breakout session.
Okay,
yeah.
During breakout session.
Good.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Ramesh, thank you, sir.
Raghunathan. Dr. Ramesh, I'm Raghunathan.
Yeah.
Is M.Tech CSE, is eligible to do the VLSI?
Professor Raghunathan, such things we'll discuss separately. Okay?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Okay, so next question is, do pharmacy department had chance for doing PhD in Andhra campus? If so, what was the procedure?
The pharmacy department.
Sudharani. This is from.
Yeah,
Sudharani.
I saw the question, Professor Ranjit. The answer is she can do interdisciplinary research in life sciences. I mean biology and biotechnology. As such, pharmacy we don't have.
Okay. I just want to add in here. So we already have a PhD student who has the pharmacy background under Dr. Anil Suresh. Who will be working on aspects of nanobiotechnology. So again, I request G. Sudharani to attend this breakout session on life science, PhD in life sciences at SRMAP to get more clarity on this.
So next question is, I am Prasant. I'm interested to do PhD in computer science and engineering. So I am M.Tech. So please provide admission detail for the session. So what I will request actually, Professor Raghunathan can address, or during the breakout session, you can have a detailed discussion.
Right now, Professor Raghunathan could encourage the student through one of your statements. Yeah. Professor Raghunathan?
Yeah, dear student.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Sir,
I'm really happy that you wish to do the PhD. What is your qualification?
Sir, I have done M.Tech in Computer Science and Engineering with good academic 73.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, okay.
Yeah, I mean, you can apply, I mean, to our university for PhD. And then we are providing in, I mean, various areas. I mean, in which area you wish to do your PhD? What is your interested area?
Sir, interested area is machine learning, sir.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we are having faculty members who are guiding in this area. You can apply.
Yes, sir. I'm interested in to apply in this session. So, sir, please convey me information and admission, all the admission details. PhD. Okay, sir. I will contact.
What is the name of the student? Ranjit, what is the name of the student?
Prasant, sir. Prasant. Yes, Prasant. Prasant, are you from Pune, whom you contacted me sometimes back before lockdown?
Yes, sir. Yesterday, day before, I have just called you. Sir, I am from Nagpur, Maharashtra.
I remember you, and your application is with us.
Prasant.
Yes, sir.
In the breakout session, please go to the session of CSE and interact with Professor Raghunathan and his colleagues from the department of CSE. Formalities that can be taken care of very easily, but your aptitude and the expertise available, you can discuss with the faculty members. Don't worry much about formalities.
Narayan Rao, sir, Dr. Narayan Rao, sir, Vice Chancellor, Raghunathan, sir, and all your faculty members and team for just encouraging we people for doing research. And thanks for organizing such type of webinar, research webinars. Thanks, sir. Thanks once again.
Okay, so we will move it to the next question from Asis. I am DST Inspire Fellow.
Oh, great.
I am BSc Chemistry Honors, graduate from Hans Raj College, Delhi University, MSc Chemistry from NIT Jamshedpur. I am highly motivated to do research.
Chemistry Mannadhan.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Mannadhan, please go ahead.
Sir, I am here, sir. So Ashish, first of all, thank you so much that for joining this webinar, and we are very happy to hear that you are highly motivated for research. So we welcome you, and after this, we are going to have a breakout session. We will explain our research areas in detail about the individual faculty members, what they are currently working on. We are happy to invite you for that session, and we will explain you in detail. Surely you will get motivated, and we will support you for the further process in the DST Inspire.
Mr. Asis, yeah. I would like to supplement to Dr. Mannadhan. We are very happy that you, a DST Inspire Fellow, is participating in this webinar. This university welcomes you to join for your PhD program. And as I said earlier repeatedly, we assure you an illustrious career. So after this, please join in the breakout session with the chemistry department. Mannadhan and his colleagues will discuss with you, and we definitely would like to have you here, provide all the facilities.
Okay, yeah. Sir. Thank you, sir.
Ranjit, aur koi sawal hai? Ranjit?
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 Okay. Ranjit, okay.
Broken.
Okay, in that case, I will take over to go for the next question. Next question is from Amal Thomas K. Hello, sir. I have done my B.Tech and M.Tech on ECE background. And can I do PhD on some core CSE domains? Raghunathan, sir.
Yes, sir. They can do.
Yeah. Prof. Jayasilan, please advise that student. He himself can ask the question. That's the pattern we are adopting. Okay. Now, that student can go to breakout session in computer science, discuss with Raghunathan and his colleagues.
Okay. Yes, please sir. Encourage them to join us.
Yes, sir. Definitely, sir.
Yeah.
We are in the
Raghunathan, formalities we'll discuss separately.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
The next question is from Sagarika Das. I open. You can ask the question directly, please.
Yeah.
No, it's not working. Not working from my side, sir.
Okay. Okay. So you.
I have to read the question, sir. I cannot open it, sir. Unmuting is not.
Yeah.
Okay. The next question is from Sagarika Das. Good morning, sir. I am Sagarika Das, interested to do PhD in CSC, but I completed my MSc and MPhil in mathematics, and I have not qualified NET.
Sir, I'm Raghunathan. She needs a master degree in computer science to pursue a PhD.
Okay. So in that case, she can go to the mathematics professor and talk to the mathematics, sir.
No. She can go to CSC or mathematics, let her discuss.
Yes, sir. Okay.
See, Raghunathan.
Yes, sir.
We can have a joint guidance also.
In theoretical mathematics, it is possible.
No, that's why I said formalities can be discussed separately later.
Okay.
First, look at the aptitude. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Have a guide from mathematics, one guide from computer science. That could be worked out.
Yeah.
Okay, the next question is Rishi Teja. I will try to open Rishi Teja. If not, I will read the question.
Yes.
Rishi Teja, are you able to talk? No. Okay.
No.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Somebody has to unmute. Hello. You cannot do. Either Ranjit or Murali can do.
Yeah, Murali can talk. Yeah. Murali can do.
Rishi Teja is talking. Rishi Teja is talking. Yes.
Yeah, please.
Yes, sir. Hello. Sir, my question is that one of my friend has done MA English full time, sir. And she is interested to do her PhD in MA. She is interested to do his PhD in English literature. Is there any opportunity is there in SRM maybe?
Welcome.
Regarding languages.
Yeah. I do not know whether any English faculty is available in this webinar. If they are there, they could respond. Otherwise, Professor Jayali Seelan will send you the link. Through that link, let your friend apply, and our faculty members in English will definitely take it forward.
Mr. Rishi Teja, I have already sent you the link and I have also given the email ID. You can also write directly to me. I will forward to the English department. I will connect to the English department. I believe that you are our student, right?
Yes, sir. Of course.
Okay. Welcome.
Yes, sir.
Murali, sir, can you unmute Lova Raju?
Yes, sir. I'm doing it. Yes, sir. Yeah, we unmuted him.
Yeah.
Mr. Lova Raju, can you please talk? If you're not able to,
person who asked the question earlier from Vignan.
I think Mr. Lova Raju is not able to talk. His question is, please provide the PDF programs in future at SRMAP.
Okay. Same thing as Vice Chancellor said.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We will communicate. Yes.
That's the question up to now, sir.
Okay. Then if there are no further questions, we are very happy that there was a lot of discussion and interaction. All of us are interested to encourage, motivate, and welcome those students to join SRMAP for their PhD programs in different disciplines. We thank all the faculty members, our beloved Vice Chancellor, deans, and the prospective candidates for kindly participating in this webinar. Now, the candidates and faculty members could go to the breakout sessions as have been planned earlier. Thank you very much. We will also join in some of the breakout sessions. Yeah. Okay. Murali?
Yes, sir.
So now, madam.
I'm opening the breakout rooms, sir.
Yeah, breakout sessions. So those who are interested, according to their interest, they can join their sessions. It's like going to any parallel session of their choice. Okay, sir, Vice Chancellor, sir. Thank you very much.
My pleasure, sir.
For kindly addressing all of us.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you,
sir.
Thank you very much.